Hello everyone, I am Samreen Sultan and I am back with yet another lesson on synonyms and antonyms. This is our lesson number 16 and this is for 10th November 2017. This is the slide where I've put in a little bit of information about myself. So very briefly, I'll just introduce myself. I'm an architect by profession and I'm currently pursuing Masters in Architecture from Jamia University. I specialize in urban regeneration. I am a reading enthusiast and I have a penchant for vocabulary. I really like writing and editing narratives, participating in debates, seminars. And I request you guys to please give 5 stars if you like these lessons that I'm making. And if you do not like them, if you have any suggestion, any advice, please put them in the comment section below. And I promise I'll get through all of those comment suggestions and everything. And I'll make sure that I incorporate each and every advice of yours in my upcoming lessons. Also, if you have any queries, put them in the comment section below. And do not forget to share the video for the benefit of others. So keep recommending all my videos. Follow me at this link which is given below. Okay, so this is the slide where I've put in the pair of words that we're going to discuss today. The first one is wide, narrow, rise, fall, young, old, together, apart. So these are simply like sorted words. They're not very new in nature, but definitely their synonyms and antonyms will make you guys have an interesting set of dictionary altogether. And the first pair of words, like very quickly we'll begin with our lesson, and here it goes. Wide, narrow. Wide basically means kisi bhi cheez ka chauda ho jana, matlab jo koi cheez chaudi hoti hai jab apne नॉर्मल फॉर्म से, या जो उसका जो यूजुअल फॉर्म होता है वो उससे हटकर अपने आप को थोड़ा वाइडन अप करती है, थोड़ा एक्सपैंड करती है. फॉर एग्जांपल, यू कैन सी द वाइड गैप बिटवीन द टू बिल्डिंग्स विच आर प्लेस्ड ओवर हियर. सिमिलरली, नैरो ऑन द अदर हैंड बेसिकली मीन्स इन दो चीज़ों के बीच में गैप कम होता है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, यू कम अक्रॉस अ लॉट ऑफ नैरो लेन्स इन मोरिंडा, और यू कम अक्रॉस अ लॉट ऑफ नैरो लेन्स इन फ्यू विलेजेस ऑफ ऑस्ट्रेलिया. For example, in the graphic below, you can see how narrow this lane is, that only one person at a time can actually climb these steps. If you like, you can't even imagine two people at a time climbing these steps. So that is what narrow means. Wide is basically having considerable or great extent from side to side, broad in other words. And the synonyms of the word wide are large, loose, vast. On the other hand, we have the word narrow, which is the antonym of the word wide. It basically means of little breadth or width, not broad or wide, not as wide as usual or expected. So narrow basically, for example, like if I'll put it in a sentence to make things clearer for you, such a narrow lane, such a narrow-minded person. So, you know, you often use it in a with a different connotation altogether when you tend to attack on the ideology of a person. So, in that case, you often call people that how narrow-minded he is. Like, he doesn't have a broad vision. Like, obviously, our past generations, there are times when we tend to misunderstand them, and we often by mistake only we call them how narrow-minded you are, because you don't know what exactly is going on in the contemporary world. But it's not like that always, so we should avoid such a passing such a remark on people. But it's just there to, you know, clarify the meaning of the word narrow. So the synonyms of the word narrow are tight, thin, limited. The next pair of words is rise, fall. Rise ka matlab hota hai uchaiyan chuna. जैसे हम कई बार किसी को कॉम्प्लीमेंट देते हैं, या फिर यू नो यू कम अक्रॉस योर जूनियर्स एंड यू विश फॉर देम दैट मे यू राइज इन योर फ्यूचर एंड मे यू हैव अ वेरी सक्सेसफुल फ्यूचर. सो यू नो ऑल वेज यू विल फाइंड बिल्डिंग्स इन अमेरिका और इन US विच आर लाइक रियली टॉल, लाइक देयर टॉल टावर्स. सो दे आर राइजिंग, they're rising. Or sometimes you often come across people in a reality show, like this show that was coming up on TV last night. I was watching some Chote Ustad sort of a show, where these young talents are actually, you know, they are given a platform and they are made to sing on the stage. So they are also called rising stars, because they tend to act like rising stars of our country, because obviously they are talented people and you are enhancing their talent by giving them a platform. So they are called rising stars. They have a lot of scope to you know, touch the sky. On the other hand, fall ka matlab hota hai gir jana. Just you can see this hut has actually fallen off. Why? Because of mainly a windstorm that has stuck in the area, or any sort of a disaster that has taken place in any area. So a lot of buildings fall because they're not structurally built in a manner that their foundations would support any natural disaster. Rise is basically to get up from a lying, sitting or kneeling posture. Assume on an upright position in that case. So the synonyms of the word rise are boost, growth, height. On the other hand, you have the word fall, which is the antonym of the word rise. It basically means to drop or descend under the force of gravity as to a lower place through loss or lack of support. Like I gave you the examples of buildings when they're not strengthened properly, when they're not structured in the right manner. So the synonyms of the word fall are drop, dip, slip, decline. Okay, so the next pair of words are young, old. Young is a very simple word. Like you always come across people saying, yeah, you're such a young girl, innocent, and you don't know how to make decisions in your life. So for you, for example, in the graphic, you can see how young this girl is. Kitni choti hai wo umar mein. Old, on the other hand, basically means anybody who has aged with time. You can see this frail woman who has, her skin is almost coming out, and you can see the age on her face. So, इसका मतलब यही होता है कि आप कोई चीज़ जो है उम्र के साथ बढ़ती जा रही है, कोई उम्र दराज होता जा रहा है, तो उसको हम old बोलते हैं. और oldness, when you tend to get old in life, you know, a lot of things come along with that, like she had a frail skin. So, it's painful to see our own people grow old, but it's inevitable and it's a part of life. And everybody will age with time. It's the fact. It's a fact. It's a true, universal truth. So, young basically means being in the first or early stage of life or growth. And in place of young, you can use the synonyms which are new, youthful, blooming. For example, blooming flower. So, that flower has just, taken... that flower has just come into existence. It has just, it's a newly born flower. So you say that blooming flower. Okay. Old, on the other hand, which is the antonym of the word young, basically means far advanced in the years of one's or its life. And the synonyms of the word old are senior, veteran, elderly. Okay. The next pair of words are together, apart. Together ka matlab hota hai saath mein rehna. जब दो लोग साथ में रहते हैं, when they are a companion to each other, when they are supporting each other in all the thick and thin, through all the thick and thin. And apart is basically, when two people, they separate. दो लोग जब अलग हो जाते हैं, distanced हो जाते हैं, gap आ जाता है लोगों के बीच में. It can be for any reason, but basically apart is to, get separated. Together is basically into or in one gathering, company, mass, place or body. And the synonyms of the word together are calm, in sync, cool. So you say na that talks that you're going to present in the debate today are in sync with the local audience. So the local audience would really be able to address whatever you're saying, and it'll be able to... acknowledge it, it'll be able to enjoy it because they'll be able to relate with it. So things are in sync. All right. Apart, on the other hand, basically means into pieces or parts to some pieces. The synonyms of the word apart are afar, alone, and away. So all these words can be used in place of apart. So this is a task for you that you'll try making sentences of all these words. Put each of these words in place of apart and together and see if it works, because there would be times when these words would not work in a sentence because they're often used in a different context, but they are definitely the synonyms of the word. So that is up to you, like how you come up with the difference. And when you do a little bit of brainstorming, when you try putting things into place, into sentences, then only you understand it better, because see, till the time people are teaching you, it's good, you are given a guideline, but until and unless you make an effort on your own and you make sentences on your own, you would not be able to improve your vocabulary in a very good manner. So I request you all to start doing it, and if you face any difficulty, just let me know, put it in the comment section, and I promise I'll get back to each of your query. Tomorrow I'll see you guys again. Bye-bye, take care.